What if you spent a week underwater? Now, it's quite obvious if you spent a week underwater, well, you'd die. Humans need air to breathe. But still, that didn't stop Tim Yarrow from testing out what life is like underwater for 10 days. Obviously, he was well equipped with an oxygen tank and a feeding tube, but still, you'd be surprised at what happened to his skin and why. We're here to answer the incredible question of, what if you spent a week underwater? Hello friends, and welcome back to another video here on Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer all those burning questions you may have. Be sure to subscribe and hit that bell notification so you never miss a video. Or answer to a question you may have. I'm your host, Jared Bronstein, and I want to know, if you had the option to live underwater or on land, which would you prefer and why? You guys gotta let me know in the comments down below. Anyways, I'll also be responding to some comments from my first video at the end of this one, but for now, let's just dive right in. See what I did there? While we still try to figure out information about our incredible Earth, many questions about life underwater have also come into focus. In fact, some scientists have actually set up underwater labs to study life underwater. To date, it's believed there's only one underwater lab remaining, Aquarius Reef Base. As recent as 2014, Fabian Cousteau and his crew spent 31 days living and working in Aquarius to study. However, they had a ton of equipment which allowed them to do so, but it still takes quite a toll on the human body, even if you are well equipped for the mission. More specifically, it depends how far down you are. In the case of Aquarius, the underwater lab is about 63 feet deep and 9 miles from the coast of Florida. So what happens to the human body underwater, even for a week? Well, let's start with your skin. Notice how when you come out of a pool, your fingers are wrinkled? According to ecologist Ellie Harrison, the reason that you get such wrinkly hands and feet is because the surface of the skin is covered in dead keratin cells, and they absorb water faster than any other cells. Because they're attached to the live keratin cells beneath, they just puff up and end up having to wrinkle. There's nowhere else for them to go. However, over time, it's believed that your skin may eventually break down, blistering and leaving you susceptible to infection. Water pressure can also make it much harder to breathe. And of course, if you didn't die from hypothermia, your body would still have a tougher time functioning because the colder temperatures would reduce the circulation to your extremities. Of course, in a controlled experiment, it wouldn't get to that point. But even if you were in an underwater lab, with all the supplies necessary, it's believed you could mess up your senses for a period of time. Due to the higher density of air in the habitat, it's believed there are fewer parts per million of food odors mixed with the air, making it harder for your nose and even mouth to detect. On top of this, it's believed the thicker air down under pulls heat from those temporarily living down there, which in turn causes people's metabolism to work harder to maintain body temperature, which means you'd probably eat a lot more than you're used to. Sight itself doesn't seem to change all that much. Aside from lower amounts of light, the eyes seem to adjust quite well. But the lack of sun could lead to a deficiency of vitamin D and would lead to your skin becoming much more pale than normal. So to wrap up, living underwater for a week would most likely result in your skin deteriorating, and if you don't die from hypothermia, your body would eventually regulate its temperature, but it could lead to you having a much tougher time moving your limbs in general. And you'd see a big increase in appetite. So there you have it, folks. Now with this information in mind, given the opportunity, would you live and study life underwater for a month? You guys gotta let me know in the comments down below. I don't think I'd be able to do it, you know, being in such a small space for so long. I don't know, I just don't think I'd be happy down there. And now I'll be responding to some questions from the video we did titled, Can President Donald Trump Go Inside Area 51? Potato VA said, plot twist, Trump started the Facebook event. Could you imagine? That would make him something. LogicsR6 said, someone watching this video has made it their life goal to become president of the USA just to see dem aliens. Well, if you're talking about me being that person, then you are right, my friend. Jim Vasquez said, imagine Trump leading the charge on horseback. Imagine if he led the charge on horseback with a bunch of Kyles behind him and an energy drink in his hand. Red Bull though, not Monster. Only Kyles drink Monster. Alright, and that does it for this one, guys. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein. If you guys enjoyed the video, share it with a friend, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe so you guys never miss a video. As always, feel free to drop us some questions in the comments down below of what you'd like us to cover next, and we'll speak soon.